Welcome back. In week 3, we will learn about, continue learning about supervised learning, and we will move on to unsupervised learning. These are the topics that I will be covering this week. You can learn more about these topics by going through the links given here. If you want to use just one resource, then you can use this practical machine learning with Python book, or you can go use this course too. So I'm writing a series on ML, so you can follow me on Medium to stay updated. Let's move on to your nearest neighbors. Okay, nearest neighbors, KNN, as commonly called. KNN makes predictions using the training data set directly. Predictions are made for a new instance by searching through the entire training set for the three most similar instances and summarizing the output variables for those three instances. For regression, this might be the mean output variable. In classification, this might be the mode class value. Moving on to the next topic, decision trees regression. Decision trees are a type of supervised ML where the data is continuously split according to a certain parameter. The tree can be explained by two entities, namely decision nodes and leaves. Leaves are the decisions for the final outcomes, and the decision nodes are where the data is split. You can see this picture, for example. Question is a person fit? So here it is given that if age is less than 30, yes. If eats a lot of pizzas, yes, then unfit. Then if age is less than 30, yes. Eats a lot of pizzas, no. Then he is fit. Next is, if age is not less than 30, so exercises in the morning. If yes, then fit. No, then unfit. So coming on to the next topic, random forest regression. Random in random forest regression comes from the fact that the algo trains each individual decision tree with different subsets of training data, and each node of each decision tree is split using a randomly selected attribute from the data. By introducing this element of randomness, the algorithm is able to create the models that are not correlated with each other. This results in possible errors being spread out evenly throughout the model, meaning that they will eventually be cancelled out through the majority of voting using the strategy of random forest models. Now, there comes cross-validation and hyperparameter tuning. So, what are they? In ML, two tasks are commonly done at the same time in data pipelines, and these are cross-validation and hyperparameter tuning. So cross-validation is the process of training learners using one set of data and testing it using a different set. And parameter tuning or hyperparameter tuning is the process of selecting the values for a model's parameters that maximize the accuracy of the model. Now coming on to unsupervised learning, there comes clustering. Clustering is the task of dividing the population or data points into a number of groups, such that data points in the same groups are more similar to other data points in the same group than those in other groups. In simple words, the aim is to segregate groups with similar traits and assign them into clusters. Now, in clustering comes k-means clustering, hierarchical clustering. K-means clustering. K-means clustering is a type of unsupervised learning which is used when you have unlabeled data, that is data without defined categories or groups. Goal of this algo is to find groups in the data with the number of loops represented by the variable q. The algorithm works iteratively to assign each data point to one of k groups based on the features that are provided. Coming on to hierarchical clustering. Hierarchical clustering, as the name suggests, is an algo that builds hierarchy of clusters. This algo starts with all the data points assigned to a cluster of their own. Then two nearest clusters are merged into the same cluster. In the end, this algo terminates when there is only one single cluster left. In the next week, we will continue learning about unsupervised machine learning, and we will move on to the third type of ML, that is reinforced learning. Thanks for watching.